Hello everyone, welcome to Intellipaat, and we are back again with another interesting video on versus topic. So guys, if we talk about web development, we are all aware of JavaScript's recognition in the current industry and how widely it is being used, right? But when it comes to larger and complex applications, working with JavaScript would not be a good choice because it lacks some of the features and functionalities. And due to that, most of the web developers out there felt a need of having something more versatile with advanced features and better code structures. That is when TypeScript came into the picture. And this debate of choosing between TypeScript and JavaScript has been a long overdue. So keeping that in mind, we'll talk about the same, that is JavaScript versus TypeScript. So guys, before we proceed forward, do subscribe to Intellipaat's YouTube channel so that you never miss out on our any upcoming videos. So let's have a look at the agenda for this video. First and foremost, we'll discuss the basics of JavaScript and TypeScript. After that, how it came into existence. Then the features of JavaScript and TypeScript. Why TypeScript is in demand currently, which one of them is better to use in terms of compilation, prototyping, and data binding. At last, what would be your expected salary if you're opting for either of them? We'll also have a short quiz based on the video. Make sure you put down your answers in the comment section below to know if you're correct. Also guys, if you're looking for courses in trending technologies, then do visit Intellipaat.com. Alright guys, now without any further delays, let's get started. So guys, now let us take an introductory level of knowledge about TypeScript and JavaScript, and further we'll go into the detail of them, right? So first and foremost, what is JavaScript? So JavaScript is a popular programming language of web technology and is a scripting language by using which you can create interactive web pages. And it is majorly used for creating client-side dynamic pages, and the programs that we write in JavaScript are known as scripts. And scripts can be written in HTML pages, and you can save the source file with .html or .js extension. The program gets executed as the HTML page gets loaded. So scripts are executed as plain text, and you don't need any special preparation or compilation in order to run these programs. You can run JavaScript with other technologies such as XML, REST APIs, etc. Right? Now moving forward to our next point, that is, what is TypeScript? So TypeScript is an object-oriented programming language, and it is open source, and it is a combination of JavaScript and some additional features like static typing, classes, and interface. It contains types, so that is why people also refer this as modern generation JavaScript development language. There is a concept called as typing in this, using which you can create types, declare types, and you must ensure that the type checking happens during the type compilation process. You can also say that TypeScript is a superset of JavaScript and contains a few syntax features that you can put into JavaScript code as well, but not necessarily. If you're writing a JavaScript, it is a valid TypeScript. If you want, you can add a little bit of TypeScript features and still it will be a valid TypeScript for you. So even if you're adding complete TypeScript features, but you cannot directly run the TypeScript on the browsers as it needs a compiler to compile and generate in the JavaScript file, right? So in this, the source file is saved as .ts extension. Now let's move further to discuss about another topic, that is, how did developers came up with the idea of TypeScript having JavaScript? TypeScript development over JavaScript. So guys, in the very beginning when JavaScript was developed, people were using it just as a client-server programming language, right? But later, developers got to know that it can also be used as a server-side programming language. As people were using more and more JavaScript, it started getting heavier and more complex. Because of that, developers were not able to fulfill the requirement of object-oriented programming language in JavaScript. That is how TypeScript came into the picture in order to bridge the gap. Right. So guys, now let's move forward and discuss why TypeScript and why JavaScript. First and foremost, why JavaScript? And normally JavaScript is considered as a design tool for small application, which has a few lines of code, that is small scripts. You can compile and run JavaScript in any browser. JavaScript also allows cross compilation, right? So, and also you can extend JavaScript in order to write the large applications. So moving further, that is to TypeScript. So TypeScript is a superset of JavaScript, as I explained earlier. TypeScript supports JS API documentation and JS libraries as well. You can convert TypeScript code into a plain JavaScript code. And TypeScript is optionally typed scripting language. That means you can write the source code as per the requirement if you want to add typing with JavaScript or complete typing. It is applicable in TypeScript. TypeScript has object-oriented programming technique and better code structure as compared to JavaScript. If you're using TypeScript, then it'll also help you to extend the language beyond the standard decorators, right? So guys, now we have discussed about why you should TypeScript and why you should use JavaScript, right? And about what exactly are these both of them. Right. Now let us move forward and discuss about the pros and cons of using TypeScript over JavaScript. So first and foremost guys, biggest advantage of using TypeScript is it's always highlights errors at compilation time during the time of development, right? Whereas if you use JavaScript, errors gets pointed out at the runtime itself, right? So you can run TypeScript on any browser or JavaScript engine. TypeScript includes a feature that is strongly typed or supports static typing. And static typing helps us for checking the type correctness at compile time. But this feature is not available in JavaScript. So you can run TypeScript on any browser or JavaScript engine, right? So TypeScript includes a feature that is strongly typed or supports static typing. And static typing helps us for checking the type correctness at compile time. But this feature is not available in JavaScript. TypeScript also has a namespace concept by defining a module. An additional benefit of using TypeScript is it allows great tooling supports with IntelliSense, which provides active hints as the code is added, right? In other words, you can say that TypeScript is nothing but JavaScript and some additional features, that is ES6 features. Sometimes it may not be supported in your target browser, but TypeScript compiler can compile the .ts files into ES3, ES4, and ES5 as well. Frameworks like Angular 2 also uses TypeScript as a programming language. Now let us move forward towards the cons, right? So usually TypeScript takes a longer time to compile the code as compared to JavaScript, and it does not support abstract classes, right? If you run the TypeScript application in the browser, a compilation step is needed in order to transform the TypeScript into the JavaScript. So guys, as we had discussed about the pros and cons of using JavaScript over TypeScript or vice versa, now let us move forward and understand the features of TypeScript and JavaScript one by one. So I will not go into detailing as we have time constraints, but I'll try to make it short and to the point. So first and foremost is the features of JavaScript. So guys, first point to note is that JavaScript is easy to understand and to begin with, right? You can use JavaScript for client side and server side as well. JavaScript is a dynamic language that is flexible and powerful. If you're using JavaScript, then you are free to do whatever you want with any object. And it has got a strong testing workflow, and it is a cross-platform language itself, right? So let us move forward to our features of TypeScript. So TypeScript can be used anywhere, that is, you can run the code on any browser, devices, or in any operating system. Remember, TypeScript is not specific to any virtual machine. So if you're using TypeScript, you can use existing JavaScript code, incorporate popular JavaScript libraries, and you can also call from the other JavaScript code, as TypeScript supports JS libraries, right? So TypeScript is superset of JavaScript. So whatever code you write in JavaScript gets converted into TypeScript by changing the extension from .js to .ts. And guys, TypeScript code gets converted into plain JavaScript code, as browsers cannot understand the TypeScript code itself. So if the code is written in TypeScript and then code gets compiled and get converted, that is translated into JavaScript. And by the help of JavaScript code, browsers can read and display the code. This whole process is known as transpile. So guys, now we have discussed about the features of both TypeScript and JavaScript. Now let us take a quick look at some of the key parameters to differentiate between these two, JavaScript versus TypeScript. So first and foremost thing is the compilation. And in TypeScript, error gets highlighted during the development time, that is compile time. But as JavaScript is an interpreted language, the code error gets highlighted in the runtime itself, right? So the next point is the execution. You cannot directly run TypeScript code on the browser, but JavaScript can directly run on the browser itself. And the next point is prototyping. TypeScript consists a feature of prototyping, whereas JavaScript does not, right? And when it comes to annotation, as TypeScript is a type language, so developers should constantly specify the types of variables, function parameters, and object properties in their code, whereas no annotation is required for JavaScript. Advanced OOP features. So TypeScript supports classes, inheritance, interfaces, generics, and modules, whereas JavaScript is a scripting language, and TypeScript considers number and strings as the interface, and whereas JavaScript considers it as object. So TypeScript also gives support for modules, whereas JavaScript does not, right? So guys, as we have quickly discussed about the parameters based on which we have made some differences, right? So now let us move forward and discuss about the parameter which actually influences the difference in them. That is codes and syntaxes. So guys, now if you look at the screen right here, there are two codes for multiplication in both JavaScript and TypeScript. They look quite similar, right? But in case of JavaScript, you have to call the function inside the script only. But in case of TypeScript, you don't have to create the script, right? So it might look a similar code over here, But when it comes to the longer implementations and longer applications, or I would say large applications, it actually becomes relevant when you do not add your objects or your functions inside the script, and the code actually becomes quite small. And guys, at the time of compilation, it will take you less time to compile this code in case of TypeScript, whereas in case of JavaScript, it will take you more time in order to compile the respective code, right? But as it goes on to the larger implementations and applications, TypeScript comes as a reliable programming language here. So guys, after knowing all the facts about them, now comes the interesting part. So guys, finally, on the aspects of salary, you can have a look if you're opting for any of these, right? So job vacancy and salary. So guys, according to indeed.com, full-time job vacancy for JavaScript developer is around 27,775. And guys, average salary ranges from $80,000 to $120,000 per annum based on their experiences and skills, right? Whereas full-time job vacancy for TypeScript developer is around 3,443, and the average salary varies from $90,000 to $125,000 per annum as per the experience again, right? So guys, after knowing all the facts about them, you must be wondering which one is most preferred or recommended to be used by developers, right? So which one is better, JavaScript or TypeScript? So, well, it depends if you're an experienced developer and working on projects or applications which consists of relatively lesser lines of codes, then you should definitely go with JavaScript. But if you have knowledge and expertise development team, then for applications which has complex and larger number of code, TypeScript is the most recommended here. JavaScript was developed in 1995, and ever since, developers are using it and implementing new features in it time and again. Hence, the job occupancy for JavaScript is higher, and companies like Instagram, Airbnb, and Codecademy, and many more uses JavaScript. Launched in November 2012, TypeScript is an object-oriented language, so you can use most of the advanced OOP features like modules, interface, generic, and other features like static typing and a lot more which are not supported in JavaScript. That is a major reason why a framework like Angular 2 also uses TypeScript. So guys, in a nutshell, I would like to add that due to JavaScript being an old language, majority of industries have used it and still using it widely. That is one of the reasons why it is a go-to programming language when it comes to web development, right? But TypeScript, on the other hand, is a newcomer and just entered the market like 7 years ago, right? But ever since it came into the picture, it is giving a tough competition to most of the scripting languages out there due to its advanced features. Therefore, one can definitely say that demand for TypeScript will be more in the future as compared to JavaScript. Companies like Clever, Asana, Screen Award, and so on are using TypeScript. Industry usage for TypeScript is growing rapidly day by day. So guys, we are heading towards the end of the video. Finally, I would like to ask you a question based on TypeScript and JavaScript. If you know the answer, then write it in the comment section below. So the question is, from the options mentioned below, do you think which option fits for the features of TypeScript? Option 1, that is TypeScript can be compiled to all major versions of JavaScript like JavaScript ES3, ES5, ES6 and ES7, right? Option 2, TypeScript is the superset of JavaScript which provides type nature to your code. Option 3, TypeScript can be used for cross-browser development and is an open source project as well. Option 4, all of the above, and option 5, none of these. So guys, if you know the answer to this question, do let us know in the comment section below to know if you're right.
I hope this video was helpful to you. If you have any further queries, do let us know in the comment section below. We'll reach out to you immediately. So guys, thank you so much for watching this video and giving us your precious time. See you again.